Well, hello and Merry Christmas, everybody. Welcome to Jingle Jam. Before I get started, let me introduce myself. My name is David Monroe, and I'm the next gen pastor here at Chase Oaks. And before I do anything, I want to say Merry Christmas to all of our campuses. Merry Christmas to Richardson, to Legacy, to Sloan Creek, to Woodbridge, to Espanol. I hope everybody is having a fantastic Christmas season. Here's what Jingle Jam is. Jingle Jam is an interactive, digital, online Christmas experience like we've never done before. And what we're going to do here for about the next 30 minutes or so, we're going to take you through the Christmas story from the very beginning all the way to the glorious end. It's awesome. We're doing it through some several different stories. It's interactive for you and your family. There's also some games where you'll hit pause on the video. You'll play some games as a family. And there's even an opportunity to do some worship at the end if that's something that you want to do with your family. So before I hand it over to Tan, she's going to get us started. Hit pause if you need to and go get everybody that's in your household, grandparents, younger brother and sister, older brother and sister, get the parents in the room. Everybody should do this. This is a family experience. It's an interactive. We want y'all all to have a great time and enjoy Jingle Jam together. Are you ready? Here we go.
Welcome to Jingle Jam. I'm Tan. Merry Christmas, everybody. Don't laugh at my homemade snowflakes. I did the best I could. Listen, but we've got more to come. I want to celebrate with you and your whole family. And this just seemed like a great way to get things started because you simply cannot have enough Christmas. Am I right? Check this out. It's my Advent wreath because it's Christmas. In fact, this year, we're talking about an adventurous Christmas. You see what I did there? You picking up what I'm putting down? If you have some candles at home, your family can do this along with us tonight, or just watch now and do your candles in order between now and Christmas. Some of you may light candles like this every year. For some of you, this could be the start of a new tradition. You'll see what I mean as we go along. It takes some patience, which is tough for me at Christmas. I don't like waiting around, do you? But these candles are all about waiting and using the time to prepare our hearts and minds for Christmas. Because this Christmas, I want you to know that there is... That is not me. Wait, I can't take this call right now. Wait, let me try to cancel it. Oops, I think I brought it in. Oh boy, it's Reginald. And in the spirit of Christmas, I don't think I can hang up on him.
Good day, Tan. Good day, fair viewers. My name is Reginald Fastidius III. I am the greatest one-man Shakespearean Bible story reenactor. And I am here so that you may enjoy my presence and know that this Christmas...
Yes, that's what I was telling everyone. This Christmas, we can boldly say that there is absolutely...
no hope! Thank you!
Yes, wait, what?
Thank you!
Reginald, we are doing a Christmas.
And thank you, my dear viewers, thusly!
Reginald, it's been a tough year, but all hope is not lost.
Yes, it is!
No.
Yes!
No, it is not.
Yes, it is! Oh! I just punched myself in the nose.
Reginald, unlike you, I actually believe there is a lot of hope to be had, especially around Christmas.
That's not what the Bible says.
What are you talking about?
Surprise, I've read the Bible, I see. Well, after performing it for 10 years, I finally decided to actually read it. And I was appalled. Oh, no, my lip. Oh, behold. I am the bearer of bad tidings during this happy season. Prepare for the worst.
Oh, I'm prepared.
To the performance art piece, thusly.
So I know I said we were going to celebrate Christmas, but I find that when Reginald dials in, it's just best to let him do his thing.
In the beginning, God created the universe and all that is in it, including our home, Earth. It is good, but don't get used to it.
Now, God didn't say that last part.
Then God created the first human, Adam. But God took one of Adam's ribs to make the first woman, Eve. Ow! I got Adam's back, rib. I've got Adam's back, rib. However, Adam and Eve broke the only rule God gave them. Apple. Oh, delightful. Help, we've fallen and I can't get up. Sin entered the world. And people were separated from God. Huh. Things kept getting worse. God called an old man named Abraham.
Yes, Lord. I will have as many children as there are stars in the sky and the heavens. Well, how do you expect me to pay for college? No hope.
Then all of Abraham's descendants were enslaved by the Egyptians.
Walk like an Egyptian.
Some of this is in the Bible. Some.
So God spoke to a man named Moses, who apparently wore Abraham's hand-me-downs, but he had a stick. Through a burning bush. And told Moses he would convince Pharaoh to let the Israelites go. God sent terrible plagues, like frogs. Frogs! Frogs, 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 frogs. Eventually, Pharaoh let God's people go, and Moses led them to safety by walking through the Red Sea. But the Israelites disobeyed God and couldn't enter the land God promised them for 40 years. No hope! And then they were ruled by bad kings. And the Israelites were conquered by the Babylonians.
Everyone, run away!
Run for your lives! Ah, no hope for you! Ha, ha, ha!
Reginald!
Ha, 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 penguin, ha, ha!
Reginald, and scene.
What? Oh! Thank you! Ah, thank you!
Reginald, first of all, there are tons of stories you skipped over in the Old Testament that are filled with hope and joy and peace and love.
Ha!
Now listen. The Bible is an amazing story of God's love for us. Really? Yes, it starts off a mess, but God had a plan to fix it right from the start. Even when things look difficult, God is still working for our good. That's where Christmas comes in.
I thought it began in July when all the stores started selling Christmas decorations.
Actually, it begins a long time before that, and it starts with this candle.
Wait, are we expecting a power outage?
No, if anything, this candle represents the message of ultimate hope. And that's where we start the Advent wreath. It's a centuries-old tradition where people light one candle on each of the four Sundays in December to help them get ready for Christmas and remember what it's all about.
Oh, what's happening? Oh, my connection!
Mom must be streaming another Hallmark movie. Mom, I'm trying to stream. Oh, no.
Well, I hope he's still watching. And all of you families out there, take a look at this as we get ready to light our first candle.
All right. How's it looking? Pretty good?
Yeah.
Yeah? Oh, you want to get that?
Yeah.
Yeah, get that piece right there. Mm-hmm. Just tie it up. Just like your shoes.
Okay, enough MacGyvering. It's fine.
Oh, you know, we just gotta get it just right.
It's right.
Okay, get it just right. Get it just right.
Okay.
There we go. Are we ready?
Yeah.
In the beginning, God created everything. He created people and his image to be his friends. And it was good.
But then the people God loved so much turned away from him. Sin entered the world, and everyone and everything was broken.
For thousands of years, people just kind of did their own thing. Things were looking pretty dark.
But from the beginning, God had a plan to rescue his people, to rescue us. And he shared that plan with the prophet Isaiah. Go ahead now.
For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder. His name will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
And that is what hope looks like.
Hope looks a little wonky.
No, it's, ooh! Get it out.
Dad! Can I call 911?
I think that's all the hope I can handle today.
Sorry, guys.
Isaiah knew things weren't going well for most people. He knew they needed to see that God had a bigger plan, that God had promised to send us the greatest repair person of all to fix our broken world. The King of Kings, the Prince of Peace, the greatest doctor, God's rescuer would be all of those things. And this candle represents that hope. If you lit that candle with me, you wanna make sure it's in a safe place because we're gonna play a game I call Light and Hoop. You're gonna need an unbreakable Christmas ornament and something to throw it in. So I'm gonna use this lampshade. I think it's a lot of fun. You could use a lampshade or a bucket, box, trash can, anything. So the oldest person in your family goes first. Take a few steps back from the hoop and then throw the ball into it. If you make it, take a few steps back and try it again. Keep trying until you miss a shot. And then mark how far you got. Then that person can pick the next person to go and see who gets the furthest away to still make a hoop. You can pause the video while we play. I'll be right here to find out who wins. Welcome back. Who won at your house? I won here. No, mine didn't get very far at all. I think I just need some competition. Maybe my brother, except he always wins everything. And I admit, that makes it tough sometimes. But you know what I realized? Sooner or later, we all face a moment where we don't get what we want. It may be losing a game or not getting a gift you really, really wanted. We all face that. Let's take a look at one family's Christmas journey that looks a little different than they expected this year.
Oh, no, I've got it here.
Okay, but remember, no one has heard from God for hundreds of years since Isaiah. At least, that's what we know about it.
Right. And then, out of nowhere, God sends the angel Gabriel to an ordinary girl named Mary, and he says, "Do not be afraid, Mary. God is very pleased with you. You'll become pregnant and give birth to a son. You must call him Jesus. He will be great and he will be called the Son of the Most High God. He will rule forever over his people, and that kingdom will never end.
You would have flipped out.
Well, yeah. Who wouldn't?
All right, girls. Can we finish?
Okay. So then Mary asks, how can this happen? I'm not even married yet. And Gabriel says, the Holy Spirit will make this happen. Your relative Elizabeth will have a child, even though she is old. That's because what God says will always come true. And Mary says, I serve the Lord. May it happen to me just as you said it would.
She just goes with it? No way.
Yeah, I bet she asked way more questions than Luke records here.
But somehow, she chooses not to let this crazy, unexpected thing send her into a tailspin. That's what real joy looks like.
Wait, I want to do it.
On the count of three? One, two, three.
You are going to blow those out as soon as we hang up, right?
It probably helps with the dirty laundry smell.
I'm not going to burn down the dorm, I promise.
Okay. I've lived through some fantastic Christmases. And I've lived through some Christmas seasons that weren't quite what anyone expected. No matter what the season looks like for you and your family, you can find joy, real joy. I know that doesn't make sense right now, but it's true. Even when things seem like they're never gonna be quite right, you can trust that God is working it all out and that He loves you so much, He won't leave you in the midst of a mess. So we've lit two candles on our journey toward Christmas, hope and joy. Can you guess what this candle represents as we get closer to Christmas? Take a look.
Robes, yeah. Robes and hot chocolate.
That's what it is.
Oh, good, you did find it.
I did. It's a little different this year, but you know what? It's gonna be great.
It's okay, it'll still be special.
There we go. All right, story time. Okay. Luke 2.
We're gonna read about how God gave us baby Jesus.
In those days, Caesar Augustus made a law. It required that a list be made of everyone in the whole Roman world. Everyone went to their own town to be listed.
And the king's rule meant that everybody had to take a trip back to the place that they came from. So right before Mary was supposed to have her baby, Joseph and Mary had to go on a long, long, long trip to Bethlehem.
Yep, that's right. But they didn't have a car like we do.
Did they have a plane?
They actually had to ride on a donkey.
Whoa.
You know, the yee-haw, yee-haw.
Yeah.
That's right.
And when they got to Bethlehem, everybody else had come back too. So that means there were no hotels or guest rooms for them. So that means Mary and Joseph had to stay in a place with all the animals. Would you want to sleep next to a sheep?
Mm-mm. It'd be bad.
Bad.
Bad. All right. Now, while Joseph and Mary were in Bethlehem, the time came for the child to be born. She gave birth to her firstborn. It was a boy. She wrapped him in large cloths. Then she placed him in a manger.
Yeah. God loves us so much that He gave us baby Jesus.
That's right. And to celebrate that, we're going to light this special candle to remember how much God loves us. Do you think you can help me?
Yeah, you can do it.
Yeah, there you go. Good job. Good job. Come here. Your mom's gonna get your sister. You see your sister?
Be gentle, be gentle.
There you go. Good job.
Good job.
Babies change things. But the baby we celebrate at Christmas changed everything for everyone everywhere. The love shown by the Son of God, leaving heaven and becoming one of us, is more than any of us could imagine. This Christmas, I pray that love is a huge part of everything you do, everything you give, and everything you feel. I think it's time for another game. And I don't care how old you are going to have some fun with this one. See, babies take a ton of care, attention, and even special food. So in honor of those 7-pound noisemakers we love so much, we're gonna make our own version of baby food. Everyone gets to pick one ingredient. It can be tasty or something else. You can pick an ingredient like chocolate chips, or honey, or crackers, or anything. Everyone in the room gets to choose an item. Then you mix it up in a bowl or blender, and everyone, and I mean everyone, has to take a bite. All you need is a mixing bowl or blender, something to stir it with, and your baby food ingredient. Simple, right? So pause the video, and I'll wait to hear how it goes. You can pause this video in 3, 2, 1. So, how did it go at your house? I chose yogurt. I love yogurt. Yeah, that could be a tricky game if someone wants to pick out pickles or ketchup or something like hot sauce. Ooh, I love hot sauce. At this time of year, you don't always know if something is going to be really great or, well, not so Christmassy. But there is something going on underneath all the busyness and the parties and noise that still leads us to that special time at Christmas. Are you ready to check out our final two candles? Take a look.
Ooh. Oh, cocoa.
So good.
Thank you.
It is very good.
Thank you.
And the cookies.
Cookies.
Oh, good really too. Good.
Yeah.
You would like those.
Okay, I've assigned parts.
Oh. Seriously, Dad?
Not everything needs to be a grand plan.
Oh, looks like I'm up. There were shepherds living out in the fields nearby. It was night, and they were taking care of their sheep. An angel of the Lord appeared to them.
Oh. Whoa, Dad.
And the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terrified, but the angel said to them,
"I see you."
Oh, I know, I know. Do not be afraid. I bring you good news. It will bring great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. Here's how you'll know I'm telling you the truth. You'll find a baby wrapped in strips of cloth and lying in a manger.
Suddenly, a large group of angels from heaven also appeared.
You can do that with your phone now?
It's a new app. Keep going.
And the angels were praising God, and they said,
"May glory be given to God in the highest heavens, and may peace be given to those he is pleased with on earth. May glory be given to God in the highest heavens, and may peace be given to those he is pleased with on earth."
Angels left and went into heaven. Then the shepherds said to one another,
"Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about."
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in the manger.
After the shepherds had seen him, they told everyone. All who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said.
The shepherds returned. They gave glory and praise to God. Peace on earth.
With God.
With people.
Can we do this again?
Feel good?
Yeah.
Yeah? All right, let's do this.
Just let Mom do it.
Oh, okay. Thought you wanted to call the fire department.
It's all right, Mom knows what she's doing.
Oh yeah, Mom got this.
So, Dad, how long ago was the first Christmas?
Well, Jesus was actually born about 2,000 years ago.
2,000?
Yeah. But Christmas wasn't just something that happened a long time ago. I mean, God sent his son, Jesus, to rescue all of us for all time.
And because of Jesus, everything will be made right again. We know that we can have hope, joy, peace, and love.
And when we follow Jesus, God can work through us to bring hope and joy and peace and love into the world around us.
So, Mom, what's that candle?
Well, that is the Christ candle. We light it on Christmas Eve as a reminder that God kept his promise. That there has never been a greater gift in this world than Jesus.
Can I light it?
Yeah. Let me give you a hand.
Yeah.
Got it? Oh. Careful. Nice. Wow.
This was fun.
This was fun.
And this is a very lovely advent
it is.
We have here.
Good job, Mom.
Get up.
Thank you. And thank you.
The final candle on the outside of the advent wreath stands for peace. Peace in the middle of anything. Peace that can only come from God. And this candle in the center, it's called the Christ candle. It stands for Jesus Christ, who has come to save us all, to give us hope, joy, peace, and love. Christmas is so many things to so many different people. So bringing those beautiful things to people for all times, for all places, all cultures, should look a little different. Christmas is only possible because our journey always takes us to this candle in the middle, the one that represents what Christmas is all about, God's Son. This candle shines so bright in our lives that it helps put everything else in the right light. That is the greatest gift ever. It was the first gift of Christmas, and it will be the greatest gift for every one of us forever. Thanks for going through the Advent wreath with me. I hope you had as much fun as I did, and I hope you have a very Merry Christmas.